The God of peace, grant us a quiet night and a perfect end. Amen. Darkness. As we experience the longest night of the year, a year filled with struggle, anxiety, and change, we turn to scriptures, seeking God's voice. In what ways has darkness been experienced throughout history? How can we find hope, possibility, and transformation in the midst of darkness today? This service invites us to prayerfully reflect on our journeys, offering all that darkens our lives to God, and trusting that God's love will provide what we need to nourish what has been planted in this time. And so we pray. We have wounded your love. O God, heal us. We stumble in the darkness. Light of the world, transfigure us. We forget that we are your home. Spirit of God, dwell in us. Eternal Spirit, living God, in whom we live and move and have our being, all that we are, have been, and shall be, is known to you. In the very secret of our hearts, you know all that rises to trouble us. Cleansing wind, blow through us. Fountain of water, well up within us, that we may love and praise, indeed and in truth. Amen. Reading from the book of Genesis. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep, while a wind from God swept over the face of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light." And there was light. And God saw that the light was good. And God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. Our world began in darkness and chaos. God saw the possibility and transformed that darkness and chaos into new life. God continues to create and recreate in our world today. What transformations have you witnessed? What new life have you seen this year? A reading from Psalm 139. O Lord, you have searched me and known me. You know when I sit down and when I rise up. You discern my thoughts from far away. Where can I go from your spirit? Or where can I flee from your presence? If I ascend to heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in Sheol, you are there. If I take the wings of the morning and settle at the farthest limit of the seas, even there your hand shall lead me, and your right hand shall hold me fast. If I say, surely the darkness will cover me, and the light around me become night, even the darkness is not dark to you. The night is as bright as the day, for darkness is as light to you. Let us pray. Gracious God, you've heard the prayers of your faithful people. You know our needs before we ask, and our ignorance in asking. Grant our requests as may be best for us. This we ask in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. A reading from the letter to the Romans. For I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus. Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. God remains present. This we know by faith. God remains in the midst of grief, loss, pandemics, and any other hardships we may experience. God remains present, walking with us, carrying us, dragging us, loving us in ways beyond anything we can ask or imagine. God remains present. This is the hope of Christmas. God with us, Emmanuel. With faith, we now offer our prayers to God with us in the silence of our hearts as we listen to O come, Emmanuel. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. The Gospel of Christ. What new things is God doing in our world? How can our grief, struggle, frustration, tears, anxiety, and anger be transformed by our faith in God's presence, in the Word made flesh, as revealed each Christmas? What signs of hope do you see in the world right now? What work is God doing in you? What work is God doing through you? Let us pray. Lord, it is night. The night is for stillness. Let us be still in the presence of God. It is night after a long day, a long year. What has been done has been done. What has not been done has not been done. Let it be. The night is dark. Let our fears of the darkness of the world and of our own lives rest in you. The night is quiet. Let the quietness of your peace enfold us, all dear to us, and all who have no peace. The night heralds the dawn. Let us look expectantly to a new day, new joys, new possibilities. In your name, we pray. Amen. And gathering our prayers into one, let us pray as our Savior has taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. And may the peace, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of God's Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God, Creator, Redeemer, and life-giving Spirit, remain with you and all those you love, now and always. Amen. And may the God of peace give us peace in all ways and at all times. Amen.